name's Alex Drake. I've just been shot and that bullet has taken me back to 1981. I may be 1 second away from life or 1 second away from death. All I know is that I have to keep fighting. Fight to live. Fight to see my daughter. Fight to get home.
Oi!
Sorry.
Get away from that molten and put your hands in the air.
Mr. Hunt. Thing is, it's such a magnificent car, but I was wondering if...
I'll spit it out, son.
If you wouldn't mind me taking it for a test drive.
You want to drive my car?
Yeah, well, I know quite a lot about cars.
You want to drive my car?
Yes.
So why should I let a miniature scrotum like you anywhere near my car?
Well, like I said, I do know quite a bit about cars. I do a car show with two other blokes, and there's a bit of driving, some banter, a few gags.
Imagine that. A telly programme all about cars.
I know the one. It's all boys and their toys. It's that bloke, the one who irons his jeans, talks about destroying the planet.
Sounds like my kind of fella.
Do you know what they call the Guff? The Mank Lion.
What do they call you, mate?
Funny you should ask that, actually.
Small rodent. A ferret, maybe.
Or a rabbit. Gerbil.
Actually, it's a hamster.
Same thing. You seriously think I would let a man who looks like a gerbil drive my car?
You wouldn't even be able to see over the steering wheel.
No, you're right. It's a stupid idea. I don't know what I was thinking about.
Actually, I'd quite like to see what he can do. It's not all about size, you know.
Fine. Christopher, let the gerbil into the car.
Better man than me, mate.
Listen up, Richie Roden. Anything happens to this motor, and I will personally stamp on your bomb conkers so hard you'll be singing Walking in the Air higher than Anna Jones. Got it?
Yeah, got it.
Good.
Righto. On it. How'd you fancy meeting the stick?
Thought you'd never ask.
Oh, shut up.